بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Welcome back, dear students. Now, we had a very interesting lesson, which was the writing lesson. Now, I hope that you did well. You presented new ideas to your class and you shared your essays with your classmates because actually it was a very interesting idea that we are going to just revise very quickly. So what did we take in our lesson, which was the writing class? Now you can see that we talked about main genres of TV films. Now in these genres, we talked about mainly one specific genre that you are going to choose, and you were asked to write an expository essay in which you reveal and explain the formula behind the film. Now we presented different ideas. You can see that I chose my title. We also chose the different parts that we want, and I have my chart ready. I turned the element or the formula here into a complete essay, as you can see. Now, this is what we did in our last lesson. So since we are talking about the idea of movie genres, let's just go back to it a little bit and see what we have next. Have you ever had a conversation about what you enjoy to watch? Now, this is a main conversation that sometimes we do discuss with our friends or family. We just talk about different movies or different things or items that we watch on TV. It doesn't have to be a movie. You can watch different programs. They can be educational. They can be something that is like the news or contest or whatever. So these different types here, we do discuss them together. Now, let's just imagine that we have a conversation. Now we're going to see a conversation between two young men here. They are talking about different genres, as we mentioned. Now the first thing that we have here, the first boy says, horrors are awesome. We have a reply, actions are better. Westerns are the least interesting. Epics are more boring. Sci-fis are the greatest. Adventures are as good as actions. Now, here we have a short conversation between these two boys. What do all these sentences have in common? So I'm going to give you just a second here, just to go back, scan with me, and see what are the different things, or actually I want something that is in common between the sentences here. Now when we see that we have here, adventures are good as actions, we have epics are boring, horrors are awesome, we can see from all of these sentences that there are adjectives we are describing. Now we have in the first one, good. We have also boring. We have also awesome, interesting, great, better. And from these adjectives, we come to the second question, which is going to be, what else did you notice? Now, I gave you a hint here. We have here better, and I did say great, but here I have greatest. So what did you notice? You can see from this sentence also, adventures are as good as actions. Now, there is a type of comparing that we are talking about here. Now, this is something that we do always. It can be spontaneously that we compare between different movies or genres. So you can see that our lesson is going to be about comparing. We are going to compare. Now, this is going to be our new lesson, which reaches here to the form, meaning, and function lesson. Now, our objectives are going to be, number one, to deduct the tense forms from examples. Number two, to form sentences using comparative forms. Number three, to differentiate between comparative forms. Number four, to use words connected to space in sentences. Now, the last one is a little bit familiar. If you remember that in Unit 3, which is what will they think of next, we did mention something about space. So we're going to move on. Now, as we said, that we are going to compare And we are going to see what is the difference in the meaning and structure. Now, first of all, before we start, let's just go back to the basic idea here that we have here, which is about adjectives. What are adjectives? Now you can see that we have here adjectives are words that describe the qualities or states of being of nouns. So you are describing nouns. Now this is the difference between adjectives and adverbs. We now know that adjectives, they describe nouns, whereas adverbs, they describe verbs. So we are going to focus on the noun, and we are going to see what is the adjective that describes. Now we can see that there are lots of adjectives. You can say, for example, enormous, ladylike, silly, yellow, fun, and fast. Yes, you can also use colors as adjectives. They can also describe the quantity of nouns, for example, like many, few, millions, and 11. Now we have here, this is just basic information for you. You can see that we have different adjectives. We are going to compare these adjectives. Now, there are three kinds of comparison that we are going to talk about in our lesson. So first of all, we have the first kind, which is going to be comparative degree. We have the second, which is the superlative degree. And we have the third, which is the positive degree. So we are going to see each one separately. Let's just refresh, and I'm sure that this is not new information. We have studied before the comparatives, so it's going to be easy just to go back and refresh our information. Now you can see that we have here comparatives. Comparatives, the form used to compare two things that are not equal. Now the basic thing that we usually use is adding er to the adjective, and then after that adding the word than, because you are comparing between two. We can say, for example, today is hotter than yesterday. Umar is faster than Ahmed. This exercise is easier than the last one. So you can see that we have here simple adjectives. We just add the er and we are comparing between two. Moving on. Now, still, we have the idea of comparatives, but this time we are going to revise long adjectives. Now, if you have a long adjective, let's say, for example, comfortable or beautiful. Now, it is difficult to add an er and say comfortabler or beautifuler, so this is completely incorrect. Instead of using the er, you are going to use a word before. So we have here, you are going to use either more or less plus the adjective, and you are going to add, as usual, than. For example, this red couch is less comfortable than the white one. Action movies are more exciting than dramas. This year's exhibit is more impressive than the last year's. My gym training is less exhausting than when I first started. Now here you can see that we have the basic idea, the same thing, but this time we are using a word, either more or less, because the adjective is longer. Now, this is going to be the first type, and with this first type, we can add words, for example, a little, slightly, much, a lot, considerably, definitely, and certainly. So why can I add them? I can add them to express how much something differs or to add emphasis. So if you recall, in Unit 1, we talked about the emphatic do, and the emphatic do, it just emphasizes meaning. So now the word emphasize or emphasis is not new. We know that there are other words that can also add the emphasis in the sentence, especially if we are comparing. Now, for example, children's TV films are considerably better than they used to be. Horror movies are definitely scarier than war movies. So when you use these sentences or you compare, you can just add a little bit emphasis to make it more interesting. Moving on. Now, we have completed the first type, which is the comparative form. We are going to move on to the second type, which is the superlative. Now, we have here superlatives are used to compare one thing or two or more other things. So sorry, we have here actually, you are going to compare more than two. So we have here, instead of adding the ER, you are going to add the EST. And instead of using than in the sentence, you are going to use the before the adjective. For example, I need the biggest box that I can get. He is the fastest employee in this office. Comedies are the funniest type of movies. So you can see that I am comparing not between two, but actually more than two. And we have the same idea for long adjectives. You can see that we have here, we are going to use with the long adjectives most and least. And before it, we have here the. So we have here, it's the same idea of long adjectives, but instead of using more and less, we have here most and least. For example, we have here, it was the most boring film I have ever seen. Emma's work is the least satisfying in class. That boy is the most powerful in the team. My car is the least damaged in the accident. So we have here the idea of superlatives, and with it, we can also add a little bit emphasis. Now, specifically, there is one word here we can add, or the phrase here, we can use the expression by far to add emphasis. That is by far the best movie I have ever seen. Now we completed 2 degrees here. Now, since we have here the word best, let's just remind ourselves that best is a different type of adjective. Now we have here, there are different adjectives that we call irregular adjectives. Now the irregular adjectives here, there is a table. You can see, for example, that the comparative is worse, the worst for superlative. We have here far, you can say either farther or further, or the furthest if you're comparing more than two. We have the adjective good, comparing two better, more than two the best. And we have here well. Now well is usually an adverb here, but when we are comparing, we can use also better and the best. We have little, if we are comparing between two less and the least as we applied before, leading us to the last one, much and many, if we are comparing between two more, and we have here the most as we mentioned before. Now, just to remind you of the different types of irregular adjectives, now we are going to move on to the last degree. Now, we mentioned that there are 3 degrees. We mentioned the comparative, we explained. We mentioned the superlative as well, and we come to the last part, which is the positive. Now, the positive degree here, you can see that we have here an equal sign. So positive equal means that there is nothing that is better or worse. There is nothing that is higher or lower. So we can say that we have here something that is the same. We can compare them to show that something is equal. So let's read together. We have here, this is used to compare two things that are equal. If I'm going to use this structure just to show that we have an equal type of comparison, we are going to use the adjective, but we are going to add the same word as before and after the adjective. So you are going to use the subject, then verb to be, then we have here as, adjective as. So we have here, for example, my book is as interesting as yours. You can see that we have here the subject, my book, verb to be is, as interesting, the adjective as yours. Also, the second one we have here, his car runs as fast as a race car. So if we have here a basic verb, no need to use verb to be. And we have here the last one, their house is as big as that one. So we have here, these are different examples for positive comparison. Now we have showed the different types of or degrees of comparing. We are going to just change a little bit. Now note that we are still in the form of comparison, but we are going to use comparatives. Remember that we talked about comparatives, superlatives, and positive. So we are going to leave the two and we're going to go back to the first, which is the comparative between two. We are going to use the same structure, but in a different meaning. How is that? We're going to see what we have here. Now, if you can see that I have a construction structure here, we have here the, we have comparative form, we have the again, and the comparative form. Now, this seems a little bit confusing at the beginning, but note also that there is something very small here that you must also add or apply in your sentence, which is going to be the comma. Now, if we think that we're going to use comparative form, let's see how. We have, for example, the more you eat, the heavier you get. Now we know that more is used for comparing. Also, another comparative form is heavier with an ER. But when you read the sentence, the more you eat, the heavier you get, there is actually no comparing here in the sentence. We are just using the structure of the comparing here to give another meaning. What is the meaning? Let's just read it again. The more you eat, the heavier you get. Now, when you think about it, we have here, as we said, that we have the comparatives here. And note that I have my comma, as I explained before. Now, the result of eating more is getting heavy. So when you get heavy, this is just a result of eating more. Another one. The harder you study, the better you achieve. Now you can see that we have here the harder, first comparative. We have here the better, the second comparative. And we have our comma, as we mentioned. Now the result of working or studying hard is achieving better. So actually the second part of the sentence is the result of the first. Third example, we have here, the hotter the weather is, the lighter you wear. We also have our comma and the result of the weather being hot that you wear light clothing. Now you can see that they all have the same structure and they are all the same as the first one that I explained at the very beginning, that we have here the comparative, we have our comma, and then we have in second part the comparative. But now we know that the meaning is not comparing, we are just showing the result of another action. Now, we are going to also read this example together. We have the example, the closer a planet is to a star, the shinier it gets. So we have here, it's the same idea, we have here the closer and the shinier. You can see that we have here our comma, and we have the result of being close is being shiny. Now, since we are talking about stars here, let's just go back to the idea of words that are connected to the planetary system and to space. Now, we did mention a lot in Unit 3. If we recall all of these words that we mentioned in Unit 3, we talked about different words. For example, we have here the word atmosphere. We have orbit, we have poisonous air, we have space station, technology, the stars, the moon, the sun, the earth, and so on. Now, all of these words are words that are connected to space and the planetary system, which we actually studied in Unit 3. So what's new here? We are going to move on. We have words with space, connected with space and the planetary system. Part two, look at this information about the planets in our solar system, which is on page number 65. So you can open your books with me. You can see that we have here a complete table. What is new in this table? We can see, first of all, that we have here the name of planet. Now we have here Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. And we have here a note that our solar system used to be described as a group of 9 planets, but scientists now consider Pluto to be a dwarf planet. Going back to our table, you can see that these planets are in the table, and after that we have here the distance from the Sun in kilometers. After that we have here radius, the number of moons for each planet, and the last part, geographical features or special facts. Now, for example, we know that Mercury has a rocky atmosphere. We have also Venus, rocky high mountains, volcanoes, and we have here poisonous air. Earth has rocky inhabited mountains and volcanoes. We have Mars has the same thing. Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus have the cold rings. They are known to be cold planets because they are further from the Sun, and they have rings around them. And we have here also Neptune has the same idea of cold, icy rings. So we have here a complete table. We are going to take this table and we are going to go back to the first part of our lesson, which is about comparing. Now you can find the exercise in your book. You can just compare in the table between two planets or more than two planets if you wish. You can also see what is the same and use the positive degree. Now this is going to be your homework on pages number 58 and 59. You are going to revise and see what you have. So after that, we have our outline for the day. Now we had the first part, which is to compare. We have the comparative form, the superlative form. We have also the positive form. The second part was to use the comparative form for result of an action. After that, we have here number 3, to use words connected to the space in sentences. Now we have a very easy, simple lesson here. It is the idea of comparing. You can compare actually between lots of things in your daily life. You can just apply sentences wherever you are and whatever you wish to compare. Now this is something that you have here. You can do your homework and also apply in your home anywhere. So be ready for our next lesson and we'll revise our homework inshallah.